a ghost in the dust of the street. My veins are crossing my hands. I would like to invite you to one last dance. But my veins are convulsing in my hands. My veins are convulsing in my hands. Thought I saw you on the street corner last night. Static banter reversed in the headlights. Late night walk in the street, I feel alright. Now I'm a ghost in the center of the headlights. Now I'm a ghost in the center of the headlights. Stop yelling that name at my window. It's not mine, it's not mine. Putting me with your addictions. Don't you know I just want to be perfect? Stop yelling that name at my window. It's not mine, it's not mine. Stop putting me with your addictions. Don't you know I just want to be perfect?
Skin. wash the tar out from my fingers. I spilled the blood out of my lungs. I bought an apartment in the city so the sirens would drown out the howls when the demons come. Sing to me your every secret. Serenade me with your fears. Scream your faults through sonic pathways. Tell me what I want to hear.
And other things happen. And it's about bodies. And it's about robots. And Hollywood. And this is the title track off of that record, and it's called An Unremarkable Birthday. Thank you. is off of, oh no, it's not called, that's the working, that was like the old title of it, like way long time ago. This song's called Push. Some of you might know it. If you don't, that's cool, now you will.
Right.
And yeah, it's off that album I've got CDs of and tapes of over in the back.
All my way into your television eyes, the pulsing pixels spring out across my hands. You'll be sipping your cup of cherry coffee, trying not to let me change the channel or disrupt your plans. We'll sit here motionless and stare out the window, counting cars and seagulls dipping down to catch their daily breath. I will try hard to provide an honest answer as to why I am still living with this bandage on my head. And I am bad at letting go, but if you're asking, I'll indulge you. I can tell by the flush that coats your cheeks. I mean, you're getting by just fine, spitting metal into blood sand. And you are oh so nice, you'll never tell me I'm dressed to kill, or if my cord's too scared to say I'm naked. And I am bad at moving on, but if you're asking, I'll indulge you. I really wish this could have happened at a better time.
So some people know what's about to happen.
Yeah.
James does. Lewis does. Rory does. Jeremy does. There's a bunch of people here who know what's about to happen. When it's about to happen, well, it's already mostly happened. What really happens is I talk for a really long time. And like sometimes people do this and they actually talk about something, like they have a rehearsed thing that they talk about. My goal is I just talk for like extended length of time, and sometimes it's actually like important. Sometimes I'm like telling you something about like what you're gonna do during the next part of the song. Like, oh, this is the sing-along part. This is where you learn how to properly sing the song. Today I'm just like filling up time, just seeing how many words I can say. Sing along if you want.
I'm pushing all of my way, 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 I'm pushing all of my way. I'm pushing all of my way, I'm pushing all of my way, I'm pushing all of my way.
one that I don't play all the time, but today is a sort of bittersweet day. It's sweet because it's Sleepoverfest, and we're all here, and it's day two, and we're excited, and we get to watch all of our favorite bands and be in a safe, hopefully, and welcoming space, and feel, you know, that we can all be in this room together, and that's a wonderful, incredible thing. And we all have a lot of just privilege to be here, I think, and to be a part of a community that is this loving and welcoming. And unfortunately, today is also a reminder that not all communities are like that, and not all people are able to have that same level of privilege that we do. Today is the anniversary of the Michael Brown shooting. And so I actually have a song that is about my experience during the protests that happened back in November after the decision was announced. So not around the same time that the actual shooting occurred, but later on when everyone was reacting to finding out what the courts had decided. And this was a difficult song for me to write because a lot of it had to do with recognizing my own place as someone who has a lot of privilege, and like a lot of privilege, and a lot of the time needs to realize that in many situations it's not my place and it's not a lot of people's place to speak up and be loud when other people are having their voices shut out and aren't being heard. And so this is a song that I wrote about trying to learn better at how to like be quiet and sort of let other people speak when it's their turn to speak and when they need to be heard. So yeah, this is a song called Martyr. To the protest today. In the Red Square we gathered to spar with our fate. In the static of megaphone roar they grew in. How their privilege should not be taken. And I hung my weary head in shame. I know in my heart I'm just as much to blame for the misguided yelping of white college kids who are just trying to make her their name. But I think that they know this is wrong, that the chains of oppression they favor the strong, to the people who scream, let us love, let's be free. They don't get that it's been way too long. As we marched down the street, we held hands, put our hope in our backpacks and made our demands. But then when it came to confronting the man, we found it's hard just to stand. But as the tension grew out to a head, they said, go home to bed or try prison instead. The futon revolution was quickly shot dead, and the scared little kids went to bed. And the usual martyrs hung back, shook their heads at the children, stuck blank in their tracks. Same story as always, the protest is fun, till the guns pointed into your back. They said they just wanted to help. We swore we just wanted to. We swore on our heads we would help, but we're always just trying to help. And it isn't the help that they need. is the solemn support that they need, and we're too goddamn loud. This is not a John the Archivist song, but it is a song that I wrote. It's a song that I haven't performed in several years at this point, I think probably 2 years, because it was a song that I wrote for an old project of mine that was called Tall Tremors. Pat Malone asked me to play it, but Pat Malone is asleep or visiting his grandmother. One of those things. It's a little unclear to me still which one of those things it is. But, whoa, doesn't need to be that loud. So this song is called Rashomon.
Yes!